This is dinner.
Oh.
And those two.
Hey. That's my straw, kitty. No, that's my straw, kitty.
Good evening. This is sort of a follow-up video to the iPhone X as a joke. And after reading the multitude of comments, most of which were good, but some were a little nasty, I decided I want to clear some things up. The Sony issue. In my excitement, I failed to clarify that when I said first, I meant that between Apple and Samsung, Samsung did it first. They were not the first to make a water-resistant phone. This I am aware of, so my apologies. I also wanted to make sure that people were aware that I was not saying that Apple devices are crap. Not really. Crap is in the eye of the beholder. Here's why I can't stand it, in addition to the other reasons that I gave in the previous vid. Let's start with the proprietary screws that they decided to invent with the iPhone 4 or 4S, one of those two. In an effort to prevent people from being able to repair their own devices, instead having to go to the Apple store and pay them an exorbitant amount of money to fix their phones, Apple came out with a proprietary screw head that only they had the bits to. I see no reason to do that at all. What really hacks me the f*** off is that they would switch those screws that you had at first, the Phillips head, the standard ones, that allowed you to take the back off of your iPhone and replace the battery if you so needed. Let me tell you a secret. I used to have an iPhone back in 2010. My girlfriend did too at the time. Her battery went out, so we ordered a replacement. It arrived, I took the back off, replaced it. It was great. But when people went into the Apple store to get their phones fixed, Apple would switch those original screws out with their proprietary ones without asking you permission. No! No! Don't f with my device that I paid my money for and further lock it down to where only you can fix it. That is intensely irritating to me. Also, the antivirus memo. Apple employees were sent a 4-bullet memo saying, number one, if anybody calls you and says, there's a virus on my phone, neither confirm nor deny that the virus exists. Number two, kitty, don't chew on the charging cable. No, do not attempt to fix the problem. Right. Yeah. Number three, do not escalate it to tier two, or basically the next step up. So don't consult your superiors about this problem. And number four, do not refer people to the Apple retail store, the acronym of which is ARS.
Earth. Don't refer people to the ARS.
So basically, Apple employees were told to plug their ears and not help their customers that have spent their hard-earned money on their devices.
I find this to be total bullshit.
The fourth is more of a nuanced point, but think about this. We as humans are continuously developing more and more of a preference to be led, to be told what to do, for a plan to be made for us, for somebody to do all the thinking for us. For example, there was a gentleman that I met once who was trying to return a 3-axis gimbal that I had just purchased the day before and loved. The thing works awesome. It's the Zhijun crane, but we'll go into that later. But anyway, he said, it's not working. It just tilts to the side. And I said, yeah, you got to balance it. Then the motors will keep everything steady for you. But he said, I thought it would do it all for me. I'm like, no, man. He ended up returning it anyway after I explained to him how to effectively use that gimbal. When a company has as big of an influence as Apple Incorporated does, the fact that they are nurturing the general population's tendency to want the plan to be made for them, for a device to do all the thinking for them, to be given a set plan to go by, is infuriated. No. Why are you encouraging people to think for themselves less? That's what I touched about in the first vid. The fifth point is, it's as if they think you are dumb. It's like, well, our general population, the people that buy most of our products, aren't that bright. So let's just dumb everything down and give everything the most popular of what they want, and then poof, off they go, being the most profitable company in their history of mankind. I hate that it works, and I hate that they do it. Kitty, stop chewing. The sixth is error 53. This was a huge deal about a year and a half or so, sometime in the past, the exact date escapes me, but there came a time around the 4S or 5 and 5S, I think it was between those four models, where if you got your phone repaired anywhere else other than an Apple store, then even if the repair went successfully, the next time your phone got a software update and the phone strongly encouraged you to download it, it would download it and install it. And then all your data would be gone. Oh no. Without any kind of warning, without any kind of, hey, you know, before you install this update, you might want to consider the fact that all your shit's gonna go bye-bye. After it was either 10,000 or 100,000 people made a formal complaint with Apple about the issue. They're like, all right, fine. There's your data back. All they did was send out an over-the-air update that got people their data back, which proves that they could have avoided it in the first place. If it was that easy to give people their lost data back just because they went someplace else besides the Apple Store to get their device repaired because they didn't want to go to pay an arm and a f***ing leg to get their s*** fixed at the Apple Store, Apple took away people's memories, their newborn baby pictures, their wedding photos, their vacation photos, those saved Snapchats from backstage passes with hugely famous artists that they'll never get another chance to get. All that stuff went poof. Just because Apple wanted more money. God, that pisses me off. The closing reason why I get so fired up about all this whole issue. Yes, Apple is insanely good at marketing. They are very, very good at what they do. Very, very good to make people believe that what they have is the best. It's almost like it's cheating. Good for business, yes. But it's like, come on, man. It's like some hockey player, Wayne Gretzky, is on a breakaway, right? Then somebody skates up behind him, and then hits him in his ankle. He goes down. Would you be happier if he had skated up behind Wayne Gretzky and slashed his ankle with a stick? Or skated up alongside him and checked him or stole the puck within NHL regulations, both of which accomplishing the same goal. I know that that's a real stretch as far as a figure of speech goes, but do you at least see where I'm coming from? By the way, I am absolutely shockified at the incredible amount of response that I've got from that other vid. So what do you want me to talk about next? While you're figuring it out, I'm gonna go out. Stay beaming.